We've seen the ram raids. They are deeply upsetting and committed mostly by children. We talk about them. Police, victims, social workers have all had their say. But what about those kids? One of the fastest ways to resolving issues is understanding them. Tonight, a very raw and real insight. One young offender talks to Tamati Rimene-Sproat. Why ram raids? Why can't he stop? And what are his dreams? Plus, we hear from those trying to make a difference.
First thing I did was rob the lolly train in Chartwell. Cops came, took me home. Never had anything when I was growing up. Like, not much anyway. You're going to your first rave raid and think of the good stuff. Grab all the good stuff.
What was your childhood like?
It was alright. Scootery, stealing, shops, malls in there, fights.
This is Jay. It's not his real name, but he is 15.
What was it like at home?
Struggle. Just had to hustle most of my life.
What do you mean by hustle, bro?
It's like go steal food so we can just feed my brothers and my family. Yeah.
But your mum? Talk to me about your mum.
She's a cool lady. Yeah. She's pretty tough. Handled 5 boys on her own.
At home, mum waits patiently. A solo parent, her son is often gone for days.
Just black for me, please.
This is already my 4th coffee for the day. I don't really have good sleeps when he's not home.
And how often is that?
Often.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Like on an average week?
3 times a week.
He's out and about?
Yeah.
That must be quite stressful. That's 3 nights a week. You don't get a lot of sleep.
You have to sleep with one eye open and one ear open with him, really. Him getting into trouble, getting caught, is the least of my worries. It's the, you know, knock at the door at 3 o'clock in the morning.
That he's been in an accident. Head to buy. What was your boy like as a child?
He was awesome. I got him some new clothes, you know, for the winter, and one of his mates comes over and he's cold and he goes, takes his jersey off, here, wear this. And that's him. Someone's got no shoes, here, wear these. He always like was caring, you know. You right, Mum? Into kapa haka, the choir. He did everything.
What was this household like when your boy was growing up here?
Probably a bit dysfunctional. Dad's in the picture here and there, always in jail. Their dad had a big influence with them getting into trouble, you know, instigating situations and just allowing it. Start off as not going to school, you know, going down to the local mall to steal some chocolate. And then he was getting bullied at school because he was big. No one would help him, so he decided that he was gonna be a bully himself.
What was school like for you, bro?
Getting in trouble, running out of class, smashing chairs over people's heads, stabbing them with pencils and pens. School's just not for me.
What do you think it was that made you turn to violence?
Because I was a bit big at the time, so which made them like call me like a fatty or something. So I just get angry and just, come on then, whack.
All of this before the age of 14.
I went to 6 schools. And I went to a course. Then I had a job. Then I lost my job. Then, yep, here I am. Oh, that's cold.
No, I get them in the seat for a while. We don't have to talk about serious things. It's just a way of making them feel comfortable and having a laugh.
Just do the size, brother.
Tom Hunt is a youth development worker at Jay's local community centre.
If I can turn up with energy, be vulnerable in front of them, let them laugh at me, that's a perfect way of gaining trust with them.
I get support from the centre a lot more than I did at school.
Tō Whakapō Wai is our program, so creating and developing young leaders is what the kaupapa is about.
Can be all fresh for your next job interview, mate.
I've known him for a long time. Like coming out of primary school, that's when he first started showing face around here. Put his hand up for everything, bro. Just, look, we've got this job, yeah, I'll do it. He was like the young rangatira amongst the group.
Learn from the best. His name's Mr. Tom.
When did you see that start changing?
Yeah, intermediate. Probably started noticing him slip away from us.
Did you see a real change in his character?
Yeah. Yep. More aggressive. More verbal. Started noticing he was carrying around screwdrivers, vice grip. You automatically know what those are for.
So what happens when you grow up in the hood, eh?
In the past 6 months, there have been over 250 ram raids up and down the country. 75% have targeted dairies or shops.
New figures released to One News confirm the number of ram raids has risen dramatically.
We've heard from everyone.
Young people definitely are seeking that much shop here.
Except the young people themselves.
When did you start doing the cars and that?
When I was 13, just trying to be cool, eh? But it led me here.
This could be just a typical setting anywhere in New Zealand. Corner dairy over here, that became the victim of a ram raid.
District Area Commander for the Waikato, Bruce Bird.
It has been a tsunami of offences over that period of time.
His region is one of the hardest hit.
We're seeing a different attitude in terms of, I don't care. There's definitely an element of, got to get some street credibility. So the general deterrence message around, well, you might end up in court, the youth are going, we're not worried about that at all. It's all about recognition. This is a time when they can shine through the various social media platforms. They stick it up, they get likes, the thumbs up. That empowers them, and that's the difference that we see now previous to 10 years ago when those platforms weren't there.
And they're very young.
The predominant age is 13, 14 and 15 years of age. These are kids. The vast majority do seem to be coming from solo parent families, predominantly mum.
So this is the police scanner that you listen to?
Yep.
And you just keep this on whenever the boy's out at night? What are you listening for?
Boys in stolen cars, accidents.
Do you sleep with that next to you?
Yep.
When did you realise that he was getting into more serious crimes?
When he got caught.
There will be people watching this who will say that you went hard enough on him.
I would agree. And then I don't want me and him to be angry at each other when he leaves, you know, because who knows, it might be the last time I get to see him or talk to him.
What are your hopes for your boy?
I want to be able to talk to him, you know, on the phone, or see his face, not visiting him in a prison or at his grave site. You know, he can be whatever he wants, as long as he's still living, breathing, not doing criminal activities.
Take me back to the first car you stole. What do you remember about that day?
Yeah, I mean, Mazda Demio. Those are just usually the starter packs.
Who'd you learn to do it off?
I just seen a video.
Have you been a part of a rim raid?
Yeah, all I remember is just seeing the car just go straight through the doors. And all I hear is the alarms just going off and off and off, eh? But at the same time, it's in my head. Money, money, money.
Do you understand the impact you're having on families and businesses?
I do think about, like, when I take their car, if I see a pram in there, I'm like, nah, we should take this back. That's not for me. I know they have a baby.
Do you know what you're doing is wrong?
Yeah.
But for Jay, it's about the thrill, not the consequences.
If I get caught, I get caught. Do the crime, do the time, you know?
Do you have hopes and dreams for yourself?
Yeah.
Do you want to change?
I want to, but it's just in here, I can't. I want to get rid of it, but it's stuck.
If you get a job, do you think you can change?
Yeah. It was changing me, that's the whole reason why I slowed down, because when I was working up in Auckland, that's the only thing I wanted to do was just work and get legit money. But then once our boss moved over to Aussie, it just went downhill.
What kind of job would you want to do, bro? I
want to be a farmer, get out of this shithole, live out in the country, new start.
So the holiday program always starts at 10 in the morning and goes till 3 in the afternoon. They don't think about the future. That's the hard thing, is like trying to get them to realise their skills can mean something in the world. Very creative. Some of them are the hardest workers I've ever seen. What mentoring actually looks like outside of all the like the cool stuff is actually like us setting some goals for you guys. And most places will talk about goals and be like, hey, where do you see yourself next year? We probably do like a week goal. We start with something small, you know. Doing small things gets them far.
Tom's been working with Jay since he was 9.
How often do you write?
As much as I can.
It's a way of them sharing their own story. Too louder?
Nah, it's all good.
He is through and through a people person. Yeah, me and my wife put a bit of effort and time into him. And if anyone's showing him love, he'll take it, and he'll take it like gold, and then he'll give it back, give gold back to you. On the covers at patrolling at the hot spot. If he's done something wrong, now mate, you're not coming with us today. Hey mate, you can't come into program today. My heart pumps for him when I do it, because I know it's hurting him, but it just has to happen.
That must be incredibly frustrating, given that you're putting so much effort into this person and then the next minute they can turn around and go steal a car.
Yeah, hard, it's hard.
But for Tom, it's about being constant.
Ready? No matter what, 100%, I'll be your cheerleader. Take steps backwards, mate, I'm gonna be there. Frustrating, but I'll be there.
Want some gravy, my big man?
Thank you.
Like, only in the last probably few months, I've had a lot of time to think about a way around certain things, you know, how to approach things instead of yelling.
Do you feel like you're getting your son back?
Yes. Yep.
Is this where you grew up?
Yeah, this neighbourhood is Mahood. I actually got a crew at the park, and I got a crew that does some out of it stuff.
I mean, if he's gonna be consistently with his friends, we know what consistently is gonna happen. If I can keep him consistently down here with me, we create that journey again of positive leadership.
Is that where you wanna be too?
Yeah. I want to make a change somehow, in some way.